for tape, CDs, DVDs, to our publication, Voices from His Excellent Glory, Declaring the Kingdom, write P.O. Box 21516, Hot Springs, Arkansas, zip 71903. Our website is www.LakeHamiltonBibleCamp.com and LHBCOnline.com. There are hundreds of free audio files there. It's like going to Bible school at home. This is the 2018 Midwinter Camp Meeting being held at Lake Hamilton Bible Camp in Hot Springs National Park, Arkansas. Sunday afternoon, December the 30th, 2018. Colonel Williams is the speaker of the afternoon, teaching on Janus, or the month of Tevet.
Okay, all right. First of all, how many of you are blessed?
Yes.
To all the services, is that right?
Yes, Lord.
Jesus Christ was exalted. Is that right? And He is what? Lord, isn't
Lord.
He?
Yes.
Okay, all right. Father, we pray that You will release a teaching anointing.
Yes.
That, Lord, I may teach Your people tonight. I pray for revelation knowledge to impart to the people, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray that the Ruach HaKodesh would minister to my heart what to minister to the saints. In the name of Jesus Christ. We love You, Father. In Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. First of all, we want to give honor to God and to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and to the precious Holy Spirit. We thank God for Director Merrill, staff, Kevin and Patty, and other fivefold ministry gifts. And as I said yesterday, we bless your gifts and your graces. Is that right? All right. I thank God for each and every one of you. Many times, and even when I'm here in the camp, I learn so much just by listening to other people. You know? How many of you know that when Jesus was 12 years old and He was teaching in the temple, how many of you know that a child can tell you something sometimes? Is that right? A child can give you what? Can give you great wisdom. Okay? All right. Well, let's get started. Let's get started. Stand with me, please. One more time. Let's do that. I believe in decrees and their declarations. I believe that our voice can be prophetic and move through the earth realm.
That's it.
Is that right?
Yes.
In Job chapter 22, verse 28, the Bible says, thou shalt what? Decree a thing. And it shall what? Come to pass. I want everybody to decree after me. Everything I say will have a scripture behind it. Your throne, O God,
is like a fiery flame.
Daniel chapter 7, verse 9. You are the God that answers by fire. 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 24. A fire goes before You, O Lord,
fire goes before You, O Lord,
and burns up all Your enemies.
Burns up all Your enemies.
Psalms chapter 97, verse 3. Lord, release Your fire.
Lord, release Your fire.
Burn up the works of darkness.
Burn up the works of darkness.
Baptize us,
baptize
with
us
the Holy Ghost and fire.
Holy Ghost and fire.
Luke chapter 3, verse 16.
Let Your fire be in our hands.
To heal the sick.
And to cast out devils.
Let Your fire burn in our eyes.
Burn in our heart.
Burn in our belly.
Burn in our mouth.
Burn in our feet.
In the name of Jesus.
Let Your fire burn in our tongues.
To preach and to prophesy.
I receive tongues of fire.
In the name of Jesus.
Let Your word be preached with fire.
Let Your word be preached with fire.
Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 29.
Make me a minister of fire.
Hebrews chapter 1, verse 7.
Deliver me with Your fire.
Psalms chapter 18, verse 13. And the last one, with the cream. Let Your fire protect me and cover me.
Let Your fire protect me and cover me.
Exodus chapter 14, verse 24. Now give Jesus a praise.
Amen. Before we get into our message, I want to share about three prophetic current events that have taken place, and they're going to bless many of you because they blessed me when I found out about them. Turn to the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse 19. The book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse 19. And I want to share three biblical prophecies that are being fulfilled right now before we get into our subject. In Isaiah, chapter 43, verse 19, the Lord says, "Behold, I'm doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive and know it? Will you not give heed to it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert." Does everybody see the word that says rivers in the desert?
Yeah.
The prophet Isaiah prophesied prophetically that in the end time there will be rivers in the desert. Snow is falling in the Sahara Desert.
Yeah.
Let me say that again. Snow is falling in the Sahara Desert. And the Sahara Desert is one of the most hottest regions in the world. And there is heavy documented snow that's falling in that region. Look what the Lord says. That He is doing what? A new thing. Which means what? That there will be rivers in desert places. So the Lord says, "I'm doing a new thing." And many believers here, you are in the season of the new thing. How many of you believe that?
Amen.
You are in the season and timing and purpose of the new thing that the Lord is doing. So it's time to do what? Step into your call and be all you can be, not for the army, but all you can be for Jesus. Is that right?
Amen.
All right, that's one. Let me give you another one. Turn to the book of Ezekiel, chapter 47. The book of the prophet Ezekiel, chapter what? 47. Let's look at verses 8 and 9. Once again, that's the book of Ezekiel, chapter 47. Let's look at verses 8 and 9. In verse 8, the Bible says, "Then he said to me, 'These waters pour out toward the eastern region and go down into Arabah, the Jordan Valley, or into the Dead Sea. And when they shall enter the sea of putrid waters, the water shall be healed and made fresh.'" Now notice that closely. The water shall be healed and made what? Fresh. Look at verse 9 closely. "And wherever the double river shall go, every living creature with swarms shall live, and there shall be a very large great number of fish because of these waters go there, that the waters of the sea may be healed and made fresh. And everything shall live wherever the river goes." Ezekiel prophesied that the Dead Sea would come alive. The Dead Sea is 10 times saltier than the ocean itself. Nothing can live in the Dead Sea because it's ultra salty waters. Layers of salt that can kill plants. Layers of salt that can kill what? Fish. But Ezekiel prophesied that the day will come when the Dead Sea would be healed. Well, I got news for you. This year, scientists in Israel have noticed that in the Dead Sea, there are new species of fishes that are breeding in the Dead Sea. There's new plant vegetation, new plants that are breeding in the Dead Sea. At the bottom of the Dead Sea, there are holes that are opening up, pumping fresh water into the Dead Sea. New breeds of fish, new breeds of vegetation, and fresh water rushing up from the bottom of the Dead Sea. What's prophetic about this? The Dead Sea becoming alive. This year, it was noted by many scientists and many scholars and teachers in Israel that there is a prophetic miracle that just happened to the Dead Sea, and now fish is beginning to breed in the Dead Sea.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, I'd like to be there right now with some of those mullets and grouper and snapper and...
Yeah.
And
yes.
Amen. Okay, what's prophetic about this? We're in the time that you need to begin to prophesy against dead things in your life. Prophesy that dead things that you thought were dead will be restored and come alive.
Yeah.
How many of you are with me here?
Yeah.
Well, give Jesus a praise with that one.
Yeah.
I thought that was so wonderful to hear that the Dead Sea is coming alive. And it's happening in our time. Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Let me give you something else that just happened in Israel just recently. Give you the third current event. At the western wall of Jerusalem is where many of the Jews pray 24 hours a day. There was a large serpent that slithered out from between the ancient stone. My sister says she's fully aware of you. Thank you, sister. God bless you. On the western wall, it's called the Wailing Wall. It's a religious site where prayers are being made. A serpent appeared to be going after a pigeon that was using the stones for protection. Israel is also called a dove in the Bible, but the pigeon is a cousin of the dove. Everybody with me here? Now, many of the Jews are saying this. They believe that there are dangerous times coming for Israel, but if they stay close to the stone, Jesus Christ, the chief cornerstone, if they stay close to the stone, then Yeshua would protect them. Because the pigeon or the bird, he used the stone to protect itself from the large serpent that was trying to devour it. And many Jews who pray at that wall, they believe that it was a prophetic sign to them that Israel must stay close to the stones or stay close to the chief cornerstone, who is Jesus Christ, for their protection, because dangerous times are ahead for them. Ain't that amazing?
Yeah.
I thought that, listen, when I heard that, I was so touched and so blessed by that. We're in the time of miracles. And we think that it's infiltrating on the outside, but I believe by faith that it's going to infiltrate into the assemblies. Miracles. Strange things that we can't condemn. Strange things that we can't question. Strange things that will begin to happen that we will know is Jesus Christ and not man. Amen? All right. Let's get into our subject. Our subject today is Janus, or the month of Tevet. Once again, Janus, that's J-A-N-U-S, or the month of Tevet. The month Tevet is spelled T-E-V-E-T. Many of you know that we are governed by the 12-month calendar. And the 12-month calendar is called the Gregorian calendar. How many of you are with me? Okay? January is named after the Roman god Janus. Is that right?
Yep.
And January, or Janus, which is the name of that pagan Roman god, is the first month on the Gregorian calendar. Janus is called the guard of doors. Okay? Because this month is an open door to the new year, 2019. Okay? But on the Gregorian calendar, we call it January. Is that right? I hear so many people say, I'm making my New Year's resolution in January. Well, I've learned not to say that when I started studying the Hebraic calendar, because I understand now that January, the true name is Janus. She was a god of two faces. She had a face in the front, and she had a face in the back. Is that right? She was a god that one face looked toward the future. Is that right? And one face looked where? In the past. Okay? How many of you with me here? All right. Janus is not the god of the open door. Jesus is the open door. Is that right? And the only way that we can get to heaven is not through Janus for January, but through who? Jesus Christ. Turn to the book of St. John chapter 10. Let's look at verses 7 through 9. St. John chapter 10. Let's look at verses 7 through 9. In verse 7, so Jesus said again, I assure you most solemnly, I tell you that I myself am the door for the sheep.
Yeah.
Look at verse 8. All others who came have searched before me are thieves and robbers. But the true sheep did not listen to and obey them. Now look at verse 9 closely. I am the door. Jesus said that what? I am the door. Anyone who enters in through me will be saved, will live. He will come in and he will go out freely and will what? Find pastures. Janus is not only the God of open doors, but she is the God of gates. She is the God of beginning and endings. In Revelation chapter 22, verse 13, that's the book of Revelation chapter 22, verse 13, Jesus said that he is the beginning and the end. How many of you are with me here? Not Janus, but Jesus is what? The beginning and the end. Janus is a God of two faces. A face that looks into the past. The Bible tells us in Philippians 3, 13 and 14, that we are to what? Forget those things which are behind. Is that right?
Yes.
And we are to do what? Press on toward the mark of the high calling. Our destiny or our future is not in Janus, but in who? In Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Okay. Now, two-faced it. Let me share something with you. During the month of January, not only in the natural realm, but there is a lot of backstabbing going on. Okay? And I want you to think of the pagan god Janus with the two faces. There's a lot of backstabbing going on because of the god with two faces. When you look in the dictionary, there was a time when people would say, she's two-faced it. But the new terminology is, she is Janus-faced it. Or he is Janus-faced it. Faced it. And I found that in Webster's dictionary about being Janus faced it. So backstabbing is double dealing, it's being untrustworthy, it's being insincere, it's being deceitful, it's being hypocritical, it's being perfidious, it's being mendacious, and it's also a double crossing. Now, I believe that things in the natural speaks also to us in the spirit realm. Is that right?
Yeah.
All right. Our God is a God of times and seasons and cycles. Is that right?
Yes.
What we see in the natural can many times manifest itself where? In the spiritual realm. Am I making understanding? Am I making sense?
Yes.
Okay? So we're in that time where we have to watch out as a believer that we don't get caught up in any double dealings. Is that right? Or any deceitful or any insincerity. We have to be on the alert. Our prayers must constantly, God, 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 my heart, God, my tongue, God, my mouth. Is that right? Okay. Now, in Kishi folklore, I found something that caught my attention. It says, there is a two-faced demon in Angola. It's an attractive human man face in front of his body. So in other words, the one foot of his body is an attractive human. But on the back of his body is a hyena. So here's what I found. That the Kishi in Angola say the attractive face uses smooth talk and charm to attract young women. But when he meet the young women, the hyena part in the back eat them up. Okay? So the attractive face does what? It eats them. Okay? Now, Brother Randy mentioned something the other day that caught my attention. In Ephesians chapter 6, verse 16, I want you to turn there, please. Ephesians chapter 6, verse what? 16. Let me bless you with something here. In Ephesians chapter 6, verse 16, the Bible says, lift up over all the covering shield of saving faith upon you, which you can quench all the flaming missiles. All the flaming missiles of the enemy. January or Janus is not only a time of backstabbing, but it's also a time of fiery darts of the enemy. It's a time of flaming missiles of the enemy. And it's a time when many believers, if they would look in the spirit realm, they would see javelins and darts and all types of missiles in their back parts behind backstabbing. Because during that month, many pagans say it's a time when there's an increase in backstabbing. Am I making sense to you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Let's move on. Now, I look up the Greek word for fiery darts. It means missiles, javelins, arrows, literally on fire, burning in the back. Many believers need deliverance from flaming missiles. Okay? 2019 is a year of repentance from backstabbing. Now, this may sound awkward to you. This may sound strange to you, what I'm saying. The natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, neither can he know them, because he's not what? Spiritually discerned. But you know. You know the time and you know the season that we're in. I found out that during January 1st of the new year, which is 2019, it is a time when people offer their sacrifices to the Roman god Janus. It is a time when witches and when Wiccans and warlocks, they pray to open doors and gates through satanic power. It is a time when witches gain power on the earth to cast spells. It is a time of bewitchment. Now, I want to say for our commander-in-chief that Janus or January is an increased time to cast spells and to do satanic rituals. And I would say to many of you, pray for your commander-in-chief. Pray for your leadership of the church. Pray for Donald Trump, who leads this nation. Whether you like it, him or not, he is the man, he is the appointee that God Almighty has chosen for at this hour. Okay? All right. There was an apostle of deliverance, I found out, that he said something very powerful about the time of Janus, or the season of the beginning of the new year. He said, it's a time of attacks on the mind. Because remember now, Janus has to do with what? A face in the front and a face in the back. It's a time when people have mind attacks. All the last 2 weeks, all I've been hearing from believers is migraines, migraines, migraines. And I've been hearing it real heavy and real strong. Not only in Georgia, not only in Florida, but I've been hearing attacks on the mind through migraines since I've been here. Okay? It's a time of severe headache pains. Okay? Severe headaches, strange and unusual pains in the head. Because you've got to remember, Janus is what? Two-faced. Is that right? Okay, she's pagan. It is a time when people face attacks on the head, attacks in their dreams, attacks in their thoughts, and even attacks in their memories. I think it was someone said the other day, one of the instructors said, in order to fight the enemy, then you got to know the enemy's strategy. How many of you with me here? One thing, when I went into boot camp in the Marine Corps, they would not only you would drill you and you would train how to fire certain weapons, but they would also teach you the strategy of the enemy so that you would also know how to do what? How to fight the enemy. Yes. January, or Janus, is also the Illuminati god of chaos and destruction. This is a prayer month, saints, that you must pray against chaos in the family, chaos in the church, chaos in on the job, and deception. Is that right? This is a time you must pray that the Holy Spirit will protect you and guard you against any type of chaos or disorderliness or deception. Janus is called the keeper of keys, keys to open doors. How many of you know that you want godly doors to open for you for the new year? The Bible says promotion does not come from the east nor from the west, but it comes from the Lord. I don't know about you, but I want God to open doors for me. I don't want a satanic door open. I don't want man's gifting or man's graces to open doors for me. I want Jesus to do what? Open doors for me. But there are many times, many of you already know this, that Paul said something that caught my attention. He said there was an open door, but there were many adversaries. Many times God will open the door, but when you walk in that door, there's going to be a fight. There's going to be what? Some adversaries with that open door. So what am I saying to you? I'm giving you some of the strategy techniques of the Janus in the spirit realm, how the believers should war for this month. Now, when you look at Satan's false system, or Satan's sense of worship, he has introduced the Gregorian calendar, is that right? Which is a civil calendar, not only to the Western world, but to other parts of the world, by Pope Gregory the 13th. I believe by faith that was not God's design or God's will for the believer to operate their life by the Gregorian calendar. Now let me prove something to you. Many of you already know that the Gregorian calendar or the 12-month calendar is named after gods and goddesses. Is that right? It's named after gods and goddesses. It's named after emperors. Is that right? And it's named after a numerical number system. Now listen to this. January is Janus, the god of the open doors. February is Februus, or Escrucan, which is the god of death. During the month of February, there are lycanthropy festivities, which is world festivities, lycanthropy, okay? There are satanic blood rituals, and there are satanic blood orgies. Is that right? And I hear, and listen, I remember a time when I was saying, I can't wait till January get here. I can't wait till February get here. I can't wait till March get here. And I didn't know that I was deceived, and I did not know that that was not God's design of a calendar for me. All right? March is the Roman god of war. April is Apelles. Is that right? Which takes its name from Aphrodite. Okay? May is Maia, the goddess of growth and increase. Look at these Roman gods. Look at the pagan gods that have been introduced into our Gregorian system of calendar. June is the Juno, the wife of Jupiter. Is that right? July comes from Julius Caesar. August comes from Caesar Augustus. September is Latin, which means septum. Listen to this. October means eighth. Okay? November is novum for nine, which is the 11th month of the Gregorian calendar, and December is 10. Satan's false system was introduced into our lives to hinder the blessing. Now, stay with me now. We're going to get later into the month of Tevet, because right now we're talking about the Gregorian calendar. Now, many of you already know, even your days of the week are pagan. This is how Satan introduced his false system. Monday is named after the moon. Right. Monday, moon. Tuesday is named after the planet Mars. Okay? In honor of the god of Mars. Wednesday is named after the planet Mercury. Okay? Thursday is named after the Teutonic god Thor. Okay? All right. Many of you know Thor, the hammer-wielding god. Is that right? Okay. Friday is named in honor of the goddess Frigg or Freya. All right? Saturday is named after the Roman god Saturn. And Sunday is named after the what? The sun god. So, we are being governed by the Gregorian calendar, and we are not being governed by God's calendar. So, it's time that we understand God's calendar. Let me read a prophetic word that I saw just recently that by an anonymous person that really touched my heart. They said these words, I say come, I call you to my ways and my calendar of events. The church in the world has this calendar and I have mine, saith the Lord. Some have made their calendar from my word, yet they are in error. Even those whom I have gifted have their own calendar, but I am the Lord and I have mine. This is an anonymous person here. I reveal my calendar step by step. Those who learn my ways and find my calendar shall ride the wings of a bird and in flight into victory with me. I have designed the way it is. It is truth. It is love. It is blessing. It is my pattern. It has my purpose. And I know that my calendar will stand. So time is short. Come forth, my bride. Those who truly love me and fear me shall come. Those who fear me shall remain. Those who fear me not shall remain. Okay? All right, let's talk. Am I moving too fast?
No.
Okay, let's talk. All right. She said, yeah. So that. Thank you, sister. All right. The Gregorian calendar, January 1st, is named after the Roman god Janus, the god of the two faiths. On the Hebraic calendar, and listen to this, it's nothing hard about the Hebraic calendar. We're in the month of Tevet. And Tevet runs from December 11th through January 11th. And those of you who want to take notes, you can. The Hebraic month runs again, Tevet, from December 11th through January 11th. And it's number 5779 on the Hebrew calendar. And I'm going to break it down for you. Number 5779 on the Hebrew calendar. So on the Hebrew calendar, we're in 5779. On the Gregorian calendar, we're 2019. Okay? Now, the month of Tevet just comes right after Hanukkah. How many of you know there have been Hanukkah festivities? Is that right? Hanukkah is called the what? Festival of Lights. Oh, that's good. Talk back at me. Okay? It's called the what? The Festival of Lights. Okay. It's an 8-day Jewish holiday commemorating the rededication of the temple in Jerusalem. And how many of you know that Trump just put our embassy where? In Jerusalem. Yes. Is that right? Yeah. The Hebrew calendar is prophetic. And let me say this to you, and I say this from my heart. It is not the Kabbalah. It is not Jewish mysticism. Okay? The Hebrew calendar is a prophetic calendar. It is not the Kabbalah. It is not Jewish mysticism. Now, we're on the Hebrew calendar. We're in 5779 of the Hebrew year. The number 5 means what? Grace. Is that correct? So we are in an era, according to the Hebrew calendar, of much favor, of much grace, and much goodness. I don't know about you, but I've already seen some things in my life begun to happen already. Okay? All right. Now, 5 means in grace, an era of much favor, grace, and godliness. Believers through obedience, stepping into this year, according to the Hebrew calendar, will find favor, grace, and goodness as long as they walk in obedience with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Okay? Every month on the Hebrew calendar has a cycle of blessing. If we walk in obedience, if we walk into obedience with Jesus Christ. Every month on the Hebrew calendar is a time of fasting and a time of prayer and a time of obedience. Okay? Each Hebrew month, through obedience to our Lord Jesus Christ, carries blessings. In other words, again, there are blessing cycles in each month. Only through obedience to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will you see the blessing. Now, 5779 on the Hebrew year. The number 7 means what? Completion and perfection. 2 double 7s here, 577, mean double portion blessing. Okay? The number 9 is a double meaning in Hebrew language. It means goodness, multiplication, increase, and blessing as long as we're in proper alignment with Jesus Christ. Wouldn't you want to be obedient to a calendar that promises you blessings? Wouldn't you want to be obedient to a calendar that says, if you align your life up with fasting and with prayer and walk in obedience with Jesus Christ, you'll see the blessing for each month? Or would you rather align and govern your life up to a calendar that tells you something about some two-faced and backstabbing Roman God who opens up false demonic gates and doors, and that he is the beginning and he is the ending? The answer to that is no. Is that right? What am I decreeing here? I'm decreeing to many of you, you be governed by the Holy Spirit, because I believe that the Ruach HaKodesh is saying that God wants believers to shift at this hour, and he wants them to get an understanding of his calendar and not some man-made calendar by Pope Gregory XIII, and even involved with Emperor Constantine. That the name after pagan gods and goddesses and emperors and even false numerics. Let's go. 5779 is the Hebrew year. God is saying prophetically in the midst of evil, believers will know favor, grace, goodness, blessings, miraculous increase. But you're called to surrender your ways to Jesus and walk into obedience. Is there anything wrong with you saying, I hear people say, January is my New Year's resolution. Is there anything wrong with you saying, in the month of Tibet, I'm going to fast, and I'm going to ask Jesus to help me surrender areas of my flesh. I'm going to pray in the month of Tibet. Is that right? I'm going to walk in obedience so I can see the blessings of Jesus manifest in my life. Is there anything wrong with what you sang that?
No. Yes.
Come on, sister, talk back at me.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. But you hear so many people say, oh, my New Year's resolution is I'm going to get a man. Or my New Year's resolution, I'm going to get a woman. Is that right? Nothing wrong with that. Make sure they got the Holy Ghost. Make sure they're godly.
Yes.
Okay? Make sure they're godly. So that is the 10th month on the Hebraic calendar. January is the first month on the Gregorian calendar. God, listen, the number 10 means, okay, God gave 10 commandments to man. Number 10 represents man's responsibility to keep the 10 commandments. All right, let me bless you now. The month of Tevet, 5779 on the Hebraic calendar, God promises us blessings in each month cycle. And here, and let me share this with you. Every month on the Hebraic calendar is connected with one of the 12 tribes. Every month on the Hebraic calendar is connected with one of the 12 tribes of Israel. Tevet is connected with the tribe of Dan. Now, this is how you can understand prophetically about each month. Okay? The 10th month of Tevet is connected to the tribe of Dan. Many of you already know the word Dan means to judge. Now watch this now. Somebody gonna grab this. Out of the tribe of Dan came Samson. Tevet is a time to grow up. Tevet is a time to mature. Tevet is a time to reevaluate the work of a call on your life. Tevet is a time that you abstain from temptation, Samson, and lust, Samson. Tevet is a time that you pray for maturity. You see how the calendar works? If I align with the great Gregorian calendar in the month of January, all I'm going to get is paganism. But if I align with the Hebraic calendar, guess what I'm going to get? I'm going to get obedience and alignment with God's word. Let me bless you. Turn to Judges chapter 13, verse 1 and 5. The book of Judges chapter 13, verse 1 and 5. Once again, the book of Judges chapter 13. Let's look at verse 1 and 5. In verse 1, and the Israelites again did what was evil in the sight of the Lord, and the Lord gave them into the hands of the Philistines for 40 years. Look at verse 2. And there was a certain man of Zorah, the tribe of Dan, whose name was Manoah, and his wife was barren and had no children. Verse 3, and the angel of the Lord appeared to the woman and said to her, behold, you are barren and have no children, but you shall become pregnant and bear a son. Look at verse 4. Therefore beware and drink no wine or strong drink and eat nothing unclean. Verse 5, for behold, you shall become pregnant and bear a son. No razor shall come upon his head, for the child shall be a Nazarite to God from his birth, and he shall begin to deliver Israel out of the hands of the what?
Philistines.
Is that right? The mother of Tevet. There are spiritual lessons about Samson that we are to be prayerful about for the month of Tevet. All right. Let's look at some spiritual lessons. Samson was from the tribe of Dan for that month. The tribe of Dan is connected with the month of Tevet. All right. Samson was characterized by weakness of the flesh. This is a month that you pray, in the month of Tevet, that God will guard you from temptation and burning lust. You see the Hebraic thought? You see the Hebraic symbolism? This is the time that you put it on the altar. If you're struggling with areas of the flesh, this is a time when you put it on the altar and you pray and you seek God's face. Samson had a wife. He had a prostitute. He had prostitutes. But Satan's gift to Samson was Delilah. Turn to Judges chapter 15. Look at verse 1. Judges chapter 15, verse 1. Verse 1, but some days later in the time of wheat harvest, Samson went to visit his wife. His wife. His wife. Taking along a kid as a token of reconciliation, he said, I will go into my wife today in the chamber, but her father would not allow him to go in. Look at Judges chapter 16, verse 1. Verse 1. Then Samson went to Gaza, and he saw a prostitute there, and he went into her. Look at Judges chapter 16. Look at verse 4. After this, he loved a woman in the valley of Zora, whose name was what? Delilah. The month of the vet is the time that you put it on the altar. If you're struggling with temptation, you're battling with lust, put it upon the altar. The month of the vet is a time, if you're seeking a mate, that you do not yoke yourself with unbelievers. Samson got in trouble with the prostitutes, and he got in trouble with Delilah. Is that right? All right. How many of you know 1 Kings chapter 11? Let's write this down. 1 Kings chapter 11, verse 1. King Solomon loved many strange women, and they turned his heart from God. Is that right?
Yeah.
All right. Turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 6. Let me bless you again. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. Let's look at verse 14. Do not be unequally yoked with unbelievers. Do not make mismated alliances with them or come under a different yoke with them, inconsistent with your faith. For what partnership have right living and right standing with God with iniquity and lawlessness? Or how can light have fellowship with darkness? Look at verse 15. What harmony can there be between Christ and Belial, the devil? Or what has a believer in common with an unbeliever? Look at verse 16. What agreement can there be between the temple of God and idols? For we are the temple of the living God, even as God said, I will dwell in with and among them, and I will walk in and with and among them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my what? People. Many of you who are seeking a mate, this is the month that you do what? You seek the alliances of God. A lot of people say, so God, you may get upset with me, but you got to love me. I have family members who said, oh, I'm going to marry this man. I said, well, tell me about him. He knows the Bible. Well, that's all? Well, I'm going to marry this man because the prophet said that that's my husband. Or I'm going to marry this person because he got money. He can provide security. Samson did not. If Samson would have operated in discerning, he would have never got in trouble with those prostitutes in Delilah. Is that right? A lot of people get hurt in relationship because they are not operating in discerning of spirits. Okay? All right. Let's move on. Samson had physical strength, but he did not have spiritual strength. This is a month on the Hebraic calendar that you pray for spiritual strength. Is that right? It's so different between physical strength, physical endurance, but you don't have an ounce of spiritual strength. I've met many believers. Oh, they say, I'm saved and I'm sanctified, brother. But you let trouble come. They start manifesting profanity, getting upset and getting mad because they're not rooted and grounded in Jesus Christ. God, why is this happening to me? What's going on here? I'll pay my tithes. Hello, saints. That is the money. Give me spiritual strength alongside that what? Physical strength. Okay? This is a month to be praying for those in leadership so that the leaders will stay properly aligned with their destiny, because 10 is a number also of godly authority. The month of Tibet, you fast and you pray and you purify and you cleanse your temple. That's what's on the Hebraic calendar. The month of Tibet, you be aware of making wrong alignments, because Samson made a bad alignment with Delilah. Is that right? You make sure that whatever alignments and association you make, you better make sure that the Holy Spirit is right there alongside you to protect and shield you and give you counsel. The month of Tibet, it's time you review education for your next phase of life and start worrying about how old you are. I'm tired of running into 70 and 80 year old people. I don't know. I'm getting old, brother. And Caleb was 85 years old before he received the promise. God says, occupy till he comes. He's not bound by your time. Hello, saints.
This is the end of part A. Please play part B. Thank you. Our website is www.LakeHamiltonBibleCamp.com. And LHBCOnline.com. There are many hundreds of free audio files there. It's like going to Bible school at home.